Let's bring in language mindset. I know that as I was starting to learn law of attraction and frequency and resonance or vibration, that I would really pay attention with my mind to the words that I was saying, to even the point where you would say something, you would blurt something out that you just wanted to take back, and you'd say to the universe, cancel, cancel, cancel. So I want a deeper understanding of just language itself.
Yeah. Well, we know that language matters. We're aware of this, right? We know that the words we speak have impact, but catching it at the level of the words is already beyond its source. So even with the canceling creates a correction that can help interrupt your mind and help you not say those words again. It can disrupt that. But what it's also inviting is disrupt that you were wrong. You're not doing it well enough. Perfectionism is the only way to what you want. It creates a challenge that you then are continually overcoming, and it invites in the frequency of control. So you're wanting to control the words rather than understand the truth or the secret, which is the frequency. So recognizing a word moved out of your mouth is to go, ah, I have a frequency moving through me that I'm not paying attention to, and being lovingly grateful for the word that moved past your lips that showed you that truth. So we invite more of a gratitude. Wow. Thank you for helping me see that word. That I understand the impact of that word. I understand it's going to ripple out and it can create a challenge in my experience, but it's not because the word moved past my lips. It's because I've got a frequency that inspired the word to move past my lips. And so what is it? Am I being conscious of being all of me? Am I being conscious of that? Am I conscious of the frequency of self pouring through this body? Am I conscious of what the state is that I've created, my own vibrational state? Because when you are at a vibrational state, here's something that many of you understand from a health perspective. You look at it from like pH, or there's other words we hear you use. But what you're really saying is a particular vibration of body will only experience things that match that vibration, right? So when your body is humming a tune, it creates impact in the world based on that tune. So there's a lot of desire to change it from the outside, right? To change the vibrational tune, but it's a lot harder to do it that way because you have to constantly do it, just like watching your language, right? But when your body is in a certain vibrational state, it can only speak certain words also. There are certain words that will move out of your lips, which is why people will listen to conversations and think, I don't understand what you said, but I feel what you said, because they wouldn't choose those words. They wouldn't use that language. They don't understand that language, but they're becoming familiar with the frequency. And then as soon as they align with the frequency, they begin to understand the words, right? They don't even know where they understood the words because they didn't look them up, but they begin to understand them because your consciousness aligns with the overall vibration, right? And it's the same. Certain individuals will align with certain music. All of it's the same based on the thoughts they're thinking, the vibration inside of their own body. And so again, even if you take someone who's listening to something that's, you know, harsh music and invite them to listen to classical or something that's softer, they might be able to fake it for a time and go, oh, I really like how I felt. But their inner state's always going to bring them back to, but yeah, I want to punch that guy in the face and I need this harsher music. Right? You're always going to go back to your baseline vibration. Unless you can change your baseline vibration, and you change your baseline vibration through intention, making the decision. And so that uses thought, right? It directs thought, but it's observer thought, right? Mm-hmm. It's being able to observe thought or observe the words that move out of your lips and then make a decision about what am I creating in my judgment of that word? Did I just cancel myself? These words that moved out of my mouth? What did I just cancel? It wasn't just the words. Right? And it didn't necessarily change something. By changing words, you're efforting. You are trying to be perfect, accurate, controlling, just like doing the right things, right? I'm going to do all the right things. And this was the biggest challenge for Joy and for many who are listening in. You do all the right things and you don't get the results. And the reason for that is you can't do the right things. You can only be a vibrational match.